Believe it or not, Lowe's and Home Depot do not sell a door for Shasta trailers. So we had to make our own. Took a 1x12 piece of shelving, cut it into 2-inch strips, milled out about a little over an inch and a quarter. I milled it so the molding would fit down in there and hold the material in. On the corners for support, we found these amazingly ornate half-price pieces at Hobby Lobby. Once again, we're practically making money there. So that's what we're going to put on the front for support. On the back, we're going to use these ornate hinges. I would flip it over. I'll just show you the finished product later.
Ended up choosing. I had a couple of different options. The reason I chose this is strictly for ornate purposes. As you can tell, it is a round. It's probably a 42-inch round for a table cover. This is not to keep the bugs out. As you can see, there's a lot of space in between it. The reason I've chosen this one is because I'm going decorative rather than trying to actually keep the bugs out. This is more of a showpiece trailer. But if I were going to be using it all the time outside and actually camping in it 24/7, I would use it like more like this, to where the mosquitoes and the gnats can't get in and it's a more solid piece. That's just not the look we're going for. Also, this table round that I've picked matches all my awnings and on the front, the back, and my main awning. So they all tie together. The way that we're gonna be putting it in is Corey has cut out this little area that he showed you just a moment ago. We're actually going to staple it down instead of gluing it. When you hot glue, it makes too much of a bubble and it leaves too much space. But when we just staple this in really tautly, part of the thing is this material is going to try to sag within just a few moments after putting it in because of the weight pulling down on it. So we're going to have to pull it really, really tight. And then once we put the trim back in it, that's the look and the effect that we're going to get, which I think looks amazing. So that's why I chose my material that I chose.
And it will keep out bats.
It will keep out, what are those things called with the big
pterodactyls.
Beak? No, the beak ones.
Yes, emus cannot get in here. Oh, those two.
It can't keep out hummingbirds.
And emus. And pterodactyls.
So we have laid the material out where the door is, and we've decided to stretch it with this extra board to keep it really, really tight. If you don't do that, it starts to sag really bad. So we're gonna go from one side to the other with the staple just to work the pattern to where it will stay even.
Gingerly pulling,
but still, see how it's kind of like pretty tight as we go across. So building as we go. But that's why I wanted the pattern. Look how amazing that looks. Before we go too awfully far, we're just making sure that the ends fit in the grooves that he had cut and where he screwed in the thing, the braces on the other side, the screws came through. So we're having to push this wood down into that to make sure it all goes flat. So they're fitting really, really well. And the grooves are really, really working. Everything's painted. We're not gonna trim it until after we get these put in.
Why do you keep staring at me?
Still working on the screen door. I've had a couple of issues. Corey, tell us what you're working on.
I'm bending the hinges.
Why are you bending the hinges? A little more descriptive, please.
I say I'm reforming the hinges.
Okay, because?
They've been bent.
As we were going in and out, my clothes kept grabbing them and catching on them. And the door, even though it's the same size as the other one, it's not being able to close perfectly. He took it all the way to the very top without a gap up there. And I was questioning why there was such a big gap at the bottom like that. Reason being is because when we put in this piece, it needed that extra space. There's only X amount of space in there, so that fills in the hole from the inside. Also, we had trouble with it fitting. When you're making everything custom, our little things didn't fit, so we had to cut this off a little bit. I'm going to go back and paint all this so it's not going to be visible. And the people have just put it on and off so many times with so many different screws. Instead of holes, we decided just to make it real artistic and add the extra little screws. Like I said, I'm going to paint over that, so it's going to kind of blend.
It's a plethora of screws.
It's a plethora. And what is a plethora?
If you don't even know what a plethora is.
You don't even know.
You do not even. This is the magic door. It leads to a wonderland. Yes, it does.
The color choices and everything. I think it turned out absolutely adorable. Yay! Good job, big guy. So we ended up trimming the edges. I'm gonna go back and fill the holes real fast. But after we stapled it in, we just pulled it really, really tight, stapled it in, and left the excess. We just took a razor and literally just shaved down the side. We had to change the razor a couple of times because that wood was really eating into it. But that's what my screen door looks like. I'm so excited. Finally done. Glad I chose the pattern too.
But are you in love with it?
I am in love with it. I thought I would do a shot from the inside to see what it looks like. Ah, absolutely adorable. Except the door's not closing, right?
Except the door's not closing.
That's not a good sign. So, loving the way that the screen door looks, but kind of seem to have a little bit of a problem. Me and Corey both are apparently doing drugs today because I don't know how I'm going to get out the door. It's kind of, we forgot to build it in place for the handle. Yeah, we did that. So,
this is dreadful. Yeah. Has your memory been destroyed?
We'll share all the goods, the bads, the uglies, and the stupids. This is probably our stupidest one yet. But did it look great? Yes, I love the way it looks. I can get out.
So the method we came up with to avoid Shasta imprisonment is we found a wooden plate and we cut the center out. There's the center. And I added a...
It's so wet.
Half inch piece of plywood and a half moon in the back. We'll see how that works. Magic fairy dust. Dusty is now working on a duck call.
This is called freight check. When you have a material like this, when you cut it, it can pull and snag and start making lines through it. So when you put this on, it just takes a few seconds for it to dry. Then you can snip the material, the actual material itself, and it stays exactly where you put it. So literally, Corey just went around and stapled into the wooden part of it, and before I actually cut it, I'm just going to literally make a line where I'm gonna kind of make this gray stay in a circle, and see how these itty bitty lines and pieces that are straight, if I cut those, it would go into the pattern. So just keep making my all the way through. Give that just a couple of minutes to dry. Go back, and when you cut it, it's hard as a rock.
How many is a couple?
I'm going to give it about two. I think it says, I don't know. Read your instructions.
So the magic door now needs a couple of minutes to dry. Is it magic glue time?
Magic glue time. It is my own. We're just going to put material on it, but right now we're the edge. So when we find a decorative piece that will actually fit on it, right now we're in a time crunch for her showing. We're going to put the long piece outwards, so when we find our decorative piece to go over the top of it, it will have the fluff sticking out from the bottom. That's what I'm working on.
Winnie the Pooh had fluff sticking out. We're using birdhouse parts.
That is birdhouse parts.
To try to finish off the door. So
this is one option. And it makes a moon, really pretty and cool. But these two pieces, they're round. Part of the problem is they've got this big thickness to them, so we're trying to figure out a way to use them as an actual handle on the inside. I love the way it looks. I think it's super cool, and I still have my moon. But the inside still has this to contemplate with, so we are working on figuring out how to do this.
Yes, Alice in Wonderland comes into play at some point here.
Finally finished the door. Thank goodness. I was going to give you a little heads up on this one. I told you I was going to just paint it to blend it in. This is what the details ended up looking like. And it blends all the way around the edge with the paint matching on both sides. As you come on down, everything's blending and hiding. We got the door where you can reach through and grab the handle. It's in the shape of a moon, a crescent moon. The little details on it are just on there. I don't know how we're gonna attach them better, but right now, for photography reasons, it is set and ready to go. I am going to add one piece of blingy jewelry around the outside to glam up my glamper, but there's your little handle that you open it with, and I think it turned out absolutely beautifully.
These are the tools you need to finish a project such as this.
Great jumping catfish! Where did you find those monstrosities?